Ask your neighbor, can God use me? Now maybe ask them, can God use me? Look at them very well and appear surprised. Can God really use you? Can God use you? Can God use you? Can God use me? Can God use me? And I'll use a story that we all know in the Bible, and I've preached it here before. And it is found in the Gospel of John, chapter number 4, verse number 5 to 30. It's the story of the Samaritan woman. Now that somebody has put it there, it is on. So he came to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Verse number 6. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus therefore being wearied with his journey sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, give me to drink, for his disciples are gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, how is it that thou, being a Jew, askest drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said, Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knowest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me to drink, thou wouldst have asked of him, he would have given thee living water. The woman said unto him, sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence thou hast thou living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. The woman said unto him, sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come here to draw. Jesus said unto her, go call thy husband and come here. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, thou hast well said, I have no husband. For thou hast had five husbands, and he whom thou hast now is not thy husband. In that she said, thou truly? The woman said unto him, sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and you say that Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when you shall neither in this mountain nor yet Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship, ye know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh and now is when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him. God is spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The woman said unto her, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. And when he is come, he will tell us all things. Jesus said unto her, I that speaketh unto thee, I am he. And upon this came his disciples, and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, what seeketh thou, or why talkest thou with her? The woman then left her water pot, and went her way into the city, and said to the men, come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is it not the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him. This woman, if we would try to pick a few things about her, her past was dark, you know, dark past. She came to the well during lunch hour. She came during the noonday. She came when the heat was on. What was she doing? She was avoiding criticism. She came at a time when nobody would criticize her. She was confused as to her worship to God. And Jesus flat out told her, you don't even know what or whom you are worshiping. Another thing that I also know, her understanding of the scripture was very faint. In fact, all she really knew was that someday the Messiah would come, and when he did, he would tell them what to do. So those three things are crucial in understanding where we meet this woman. Her past was dark. She did not even understand what or whom she worshipped, and the understanding of scripture was vague. That is the woman. And the question that we want to answer is, can God use me? And I want to affirm it and say, yes, God can use us. God can use us. And God is willing to use us too. God is willing to use us too. Now, when I read this, and you know I have read this, I've preached many sermons from that, but there is something that for the first time I saw out of it, and it changed my thinking a little bit. And that is the message that I want to bring to you. And I pray that somebody will be helped and somebody will be blessed. What I discovered about this woman is that she could not serve the Lord because the compound, the neighborhood, everybody talked about her. And she was embarrassed about herself, and she was intimidated by every other woman, and women feared her, men feared her, because she was what you would call a man snatcher. If we would use a Kikuyu word, this lady was Kiumbani, in the sense of she would own by any man who is misbehaving or walking around carelessly. So men also knew this is not a woman that you can joke around with her. Now, because of that, she feared criticism. And you see, when you are criticized, you cannot serve God. When people talk ill about you, you cannot serve God. When people look at you and kind of murmur when you pass by, then you cannot serve God. You will keep on feeling guilty. And that is what the devil wants us to. He wants us to feel guilty. He wants our past to destroy our present. He wants to take you back to things that some of us, you know, I normally say this, there are things that all of you here listening to me, there is something that you did when you are younger than you are, and you don't want anybody to remind you. Leave alone yourself. No wonder when you take it to the encounter, when you see it, some of you get scared, you know, and you say, I cannot forgive myself, and I cannot forgive that person. Because every one of us, we have gone through some moments. All of us have gone through some moments. And even serving the Lord then, it has to do with us rising up to the occasion when God has done something in our lives. I know some of us, when we were in high school, we were in the CU. We were moto akuote mbali. I don't know what happened, or somebody hurt you. And you feel you cannot stand again. Somebody hurt you. Maybe a boyfriend. And you know, boyfriends are very interesting. I normally tell people, if it is because of high school boyfriend, girlfriend issue, please, you watch up one. Ine tu barua tuliko tukiandika na unachora karoho hapo ndani na kamshana. Hizo sio waacha bana. Hiyo acha. Hizo let those things not. You know, and it will be very funny for some of us, and maybe si kufanya hivyo. Are you an angel? If you never did, then a girl did. Yeah, do you something and I'm shallow across, you know, going across, piercing the heart and so forth. But you know, there are people actually, because of the sensitivity of how God has made them, there are things, they are soft in their spirit, and they felt so hard that they cannot serve the Lord. When I was growing up myself in Sunday school class, at least, you know, I normally say when I went to high school, nilinunuliwa kiatu. But the truth of the matter is, ilikuwa nimenunuliwa kingine. Kilikuwa cha Sunday school. Kilikuwa na Sunday school. Wanasifia. See, I told my father, I was a minister. Kilikuwa na katika kwa kuenda service. Anyway, so this class I went, it was like a teenager. The early teens, you know. And unfortunately, when I was walking into the class, I can still remember vividly, I stepped on a thumb pin. Do you know a thumb pin? And it hit, I stepped on it, and it went into a very good place. D-line. You know? It never went on the flat level, it went on the hill. So, and you know, I'm looking. We went to go to Kyokatuma Pareiki Association. So it went in a very good spot. And because, of course, when you know, ulienda shule bila kiatu na ni jumapili sasa na uko na kiatu sasa kulinda na unalinda kidogo So unakaa style ile ambayo hakuna mtu anaweza jua umevaa kiatu. Karibu umeiwekelea mguu unafanya fanya hivi ili kila mtu aone una kiatu. Unfortunately when I did that, one girl that was in, you know, she was my age group. And the father was the wealthiest, the richest man in Vika. He had buses. She just shouted, "Kimani, you are a thief." Now, nobody has warned you. You are in a Sunday school class, and somebody has declared, "Wewe Kimani, wizi." And then I wonder, what have I done? And then she said, "You have stolen a thumb pin ukareka kwa kiatu." That is the time I saw it. I had not seen it. Now, men cry a little, but they cry from the inside. I walked out of that class and I told myself, never will I go to a Sunday school class, because how can they judge me? And the teacher agreed. Sunday school teachers, yeah. And the teacher agreed. And the teacher was the wife of our senior pastor. I did not wait for them to go and tell my father. I just walked out, and can I also tell you something? That was the last time I entered that church for service. It was 1969 back. 69 back. It was those years. 69 back. Now what happened is, and I felt, no, I don't want that God and so on. And I entered into various places. And I felt I was not worthy because they called me a thief. Then I went to high school and I got saved. And I thought, and you know the way when you get saved every day, now you feel so good. But that church, I can't go back, but I'm born again. I came here, but it ain't a wizard. Don't be here while I give you space here. So anyway, that story ended up. Then my father died. That preacher. That pastor. And then, Situlisumbuka, anybody who was below me stops me. I just done from four, but anybody below me, my sister was in form two, my other sister that was in class seven, my other sister that was in nursery, all of them behind me. School ended. How they behaved that day, again, I said, I will never be a pastor. Never. If that is the way pastors are treated and their children, not me. And now, I'm your pastor. What happened? In the process, I discovered that God specializes in mending bones that are broken, in lives that are frustrated, in people that want to serve him, in people that were criticized and people are critical about. Those are the people that God wants to use. Therefore, he can use you as he uses me. There is nothing that I've done to be a pastor. Nothing. You can be a pastor. Look at your neighbor, tell them, where will I go to a pastor or a church? Now tell them, where will I go to a pastor or a church? You know, but there is something that God has to do into you for you to get to that level, which then means you have to overcome some of these things. But God had to deal with me that I became a pastor. When I came back from Sweden, I thought the landing was safe. Deliverance just took me in and they wanted me to be an instructor for evangelism. But they told me, ukija tutakupa hata nguru, hatuna pesa. Now I've come from Sweden. See Sweden in my now gonna pursue to my duty. Now na kwa kulala utalala kwa street. Now then again I hated church. How can these people? Man, I'm coming to do work. Of course I landed in life ministry and worked for a while. But I'm saying in the process the Lord dealt with me, because there are things that God has to deal with them in your life. Going back to this woman, There are people that if they came, Jesus would have tried to speak to this woman, but they would have made sure she does not hear, and she will only be defending herself. And that was Peter. Peter Kerereake. He would have caused this lady not to get what Jesus is saying. And I'm saying to some of you, you are not serving God because of some kerere of some people. You know, kerere. You know, they have so much that you cannot serve God if you don't. You know, one time I was so amazed. Karugano was in my choir. Karugano has been singing for years in this choir until he retired. I brought them a teacher from Tanzania, Arusha. But most of the choir members were Kikuyus. So I took him to see a professor who was from Tanzania. The principal was the principal of East African School of Theology, a friend of mine. When we landed, he enjoyed it because this man was a member of their church in Arusha. He told him, "Hata umekuja Kenya, umekuja Kenya kusaidia mchungaji Kimani na choir." And then akasema hivi, "Kwa Kikuyu wanaweza kuimba." Mwangalie jirani yako, "Kwa Kikuyu wanaweza kuimba." You see, when people attack a tribe, they attack in wholesale. Maybe it's only one person that could not sing, you know? I know there was a Kikuyu in this church that could not lead our worship, you know? Karugano still remembers that every elder was a worship leader. That's how the training we are. Every, I mean, you know, pigia guitar, but every, can you imagine, you know, pigia guitar, and every elder is a worship leader. Sabu na moja, nikimwanzia na simu, anaruka anaenda hii, anaruka anaenda hii, anaenda sharp, anaenda mai. Sasa, ninamuangalia. So there is one, but you cannot judge all the Kikuyus. Eh? Si elimu ametuongoza? Kwani elimu ni nani? Alafu, si ametuongoza? Na ni poa. So anyway, what I'm saying is that you have to get to a place where you jump a level of not allowing people to tell you what you can and what you cannot. Therefore, there are some people in life for you to hear what God is telling you have to be eliminated. Actually, Ayuria, Auzia, someone has to die. Something has to happen. 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 Hiyo ni lazima uelewe. In my spirit, something has to happen. And it happened to this woman. Peter was not there. The doubter was not there, Thomas. Judas, mweka pesa hakuwa pale. Aanza kudeal na kuuliza maji, geleni moja ni pesa gapi. Tunaweza kukuuzia galani tatu. You know that kind of a story. Anaweza kunywa gapi ili aishi milele? Yesu. Kama ni tatu, tutamuzia 2020, 2020, when you sing his name. Hako na sing his name. Yani, those people were not there. This lady was not even with John and James. The guys would say, "Look at us. We want to be one on the left and one on the right." Because they were saying, "We are holier than everybody else." This lady was just alone. And I like telling people this, and you believe me, the conversation in that story, we are only given summary. For example, the issue of where to worship. Are you sure the issue to worship was that easy? They had to struggle with it until the woman was told, "In summary, woman, worship, you don't know. Even you don't know what you are worshiping." Because she must have told him, said many things. And Jesus says, "Hata ujui, lakini wakati unakuja, waabuduo wa kweli." Hiyo ni moja. Sasa ni kuulize, wandugu mko hapa. Unaweza toka tu hapa, uone dada mmoja hapa tu. Umcheki vizuri ujue huyu, utamuuliza maswali tukitoka pale. Alafu unamuuliza, "Sasa, umeolewa? Uko na watoto wangapi?" You know, the conversation about marriage, I also want to tell you, it was not a short one. It was a deep one, but we are given summary. And the conclusion of the summary was, you have not been married, you have been married, you have been having husband, and the one you have right now is not yours. In summary. So I want to say that Because of the disciples going to withdraw for buying goods and supply, Jesus and the Samaritan woman had a time. They talked and talked. They talked about Jerusalem. They talked about the mountain. And they left the mountain. They went into something else. And they went on. And this lady, she had vague ideas about even the place to worship and who to worship. So this woman, where we read, she gets to a place, she leaves Jesus with his disciples. And that is, I think, what I discovered out of this verse. I discovered this woman, after talking with Jesus, a revelation was put into her spirit. And my prayer is that God will give you his revelation to know who he is. Revelation like Moses saw and discovered who God was. He was told, I am who I say I am. Period. And Moses was able, he who was a stammerer, the Bible does not say he stammered anywhere. He didn't. Aaron could not speak on his behalf. He carried the rod. Why? Because the revelation took place. When it is the revelation to you, you can do whatever God is telling you to do. How about David? It was revealed to David that Goliath was a dog. And I'm telling you, he saw a dog, he never saw a giant. When everybody else is seeing a giant, this guy is seeing a dog. Why is he seeing a dog? Because inside him has been charged by that God that Goliath was defiling. The revelation of that God made David so huge. And David knew he cannot miss a dog even with a stone this morning. Because I asked myself, the stone was directed, the stone was propelled by the revelation that David had. I don't know what Goliath is before you. All what you need is the revelation of what God can do, and you'll have victory in the name of the Lord. Peter and John are going to worship. The revelation about Jesus is with them. And there is a beggar there who is asking for something to go and eat. And they look at him and they say, look at us. Pretty good. Look at us well. Silver and gold we don't have. They knew a revelation. But what we have, which is the revelation of the healing of Jesus Christ, we give unto you. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. And the cripple walked because there was a revelation. Peter and John, they knew that God is a healer. I'm speaking to people here. Maybe you're going through some sickness. All what you need is the revelation of the healing power of Jesus Christ, so that you can speak to that sickness and illness in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus. It is the revelation. Tell your neighbor, revelation. When she got the revelation of who Jesus Christ is. Now let me ask you. Has we been told now that she was so convinced, she knelt down and repeated the prayer after me, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus. I'm a sinner, I'm a sinner. Is there anything like that? No, maybe. Did Jesus touch her to heal her? No, he didn't. Eh? Did Jesus say, your marriage from today will be blessed indeed? That man will be your husband forever. Did he say something like that? He didn't. He actually did not say, now we are changing your job position. You no longer be a harlot, you're going to be a minister. Never, nothing like that. Nothing was said. But when she got the revelation, she left her pot. Let me say this. There are some of us, what we carry becomes a burden to us. We have to put it down. When God releases a revelation to us, so that we can serve and remember what we are asking ourselves, is can God use me? Yes, God can use me, but I need to have a revelation of who he is, of who God is, of who God is, of who God is. In the first service, I said, at a certain time in life, some of you will also love the songs that I love. They sing about him. And they are sung by old people, seated down. They only stand up to appreciate what God has done. You know that, the giver and his homecoming friend. Look, they talk about him. They sing about heaven. They rejoice about heaven. Everything to them is heaven. And occasionally they go to heaven. They go to heaven. Occasionally they will tell you so and so went to heaven. I used to love Jesse Dixon's songs. I still do. It doesn't appear like he's dead because it is in YouTube. And I can't come and I but then the question I asked myself, hey, who jamaa amekataa kukora? Jamaa alienda. He went when he was 73. So what I'm saying is this. There are certain times, even your perception about life will change a little bit. It is heaven. What will have happened is this. You will be thinking more of what am I going to leave behind. At a certain time, we are thinking of what I'm going to have. Now, when we are thinking what we are going to have, NYS is in trouble. When we are thinking what I'm going to have, the land's office is in trouble. When I'm thinking of what I'm going to have, even pastors are in trouble. They are not spared. When I'm thinking the kind of car that I want to drive, even members of a congregation are not saved. When I'm thinking, what legacy? You know, you remember when people are young, you know, the first car you drive, you want the whole village to know. You enter through one side of Karate, you go through the other side. And you're not in a hurry. All the windows are down. So you're greeting everyone. Ah, only for one. But in America. And the problem of this, our fast car, it has to get to a certain level. Alice and the children have to come out. I try to push it on a Kahir alone. Because, amen? Amen. But whatever it is, you feel like, you know, but then you get to a place where now anything is to take you from point A to point B. Right? You don't struggle. You get to a place where there was sometimes clothes, and war. Any fashion you want, platform, bell bottom, for those that were in those years, early 70s. Alafu ikakuja wakati wa kufungia kwa mkonyongu. Inatengenezwa, inafika mpaka hapa kufungia. It was still fashion, right? Na taikubwa, na unaifunga ikiwa pale. This is a fashion, but it gets to a time then. All what you're looking for is to dress up and dress up. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So I'm saying it is important for us to know that even when we have the strength like we do now, we need to connect our life now with the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ so that we can serve Him. So that we can serve Him and minister to Him. I say it again, there was no altar call. But revelation changed that woman. And whatever she did from that point, she was born again because of revelation, not because of prayer. I'm not saying prayer is bad, but even with the prayer, we need the revelation about God. Because it is revelation that sustains us. When I received Jesus in 1972, my life was changed. There was a revelation within me, and it has propelled me. Even up to today. Have I been perfect? No. Have I fallen a few times? Has God lifted me up? Yes. Am I going to be focused? Yes. I will not allow intimidation to come and stop me from going, pursuing what the Lord has said. So the qualification for this woman to turn around and become a servant of the Lord was revelation. She got a revelation as to who Jesus was. Did you know even Paul was not preached to? Paul was hit and he became blind. Then he started hearing a voice. He said, who are you? And then he was told, I'm the Lord you are fighting with. From that point on, he asked, what can I do, sir? And he was told, you're going to be my servant. Get into the city and Ananias will come and pray for you. And from that point on, we read the story of Paul, a different person. What happened? The revelation of who Jesus is. I'm speaking to the Deliverance Church, Zimmerman. And my prayer is that each one of us gets a revelation of who Jesus is so that we can have passion for Jesus. The lady ran away to fetch water at noonday so that she would not be criticized, so that people will not talk about her. And I say this and I will say again, Why I felt this message can help someone, because some of us are actually thermostats. You remember the story we were told here? Some of us are just thermostats. Thermostats in a juaga wa kilo ni nani? Raphael, right? Our identification. Judy. Our petition. Kido. You know, and that hinders the flow of the Lord, and it has caused some of us not to serve the Lord. Let me say this. A drunkard walks from that door. Drunkard. He's falling down, swearing all curse words, right? And then he hears you preach, one of you. Maybe that time is Francis Obino is preaching, hammering the gospel powerfully. And then drunkard comes in front. And then you ask him, what do you want? He said, I want to have Jesus. And you're wondering, would he really make it? Then of course, you pray for him. He's a drunkard. And then he gets born again. We take him to class. And he's followed them. And within 1 month, the guy is sober, the guy is great, and you give him a badge. He can walk around Sunday school, greeter, usher. He can go to, he can be my, what I tell him? I'm a bear. Amanaweza kuwa my security. Ameingia tu, ameokoka tu, amekuacha hapa wewe, umekuwa hii judgment kamili. Ameingia tu. Ameingia tu. Mpaka wengine wanaona na huyo alitoka wapi? Ameingia tu. Akaja hapa kwa hoshi. Tunamwangalia, tuko kule chini, tunamwangalia tunasema huyu naye. Ametokea wapi? Kumbe ameokoka tu juzi, akampenda Yesu, akakuja hapa akawekwa 6 months in training in, akaanza kuimba. Huyo mlevi, si afadhali niende polepole ili point nishike vizuri. Huyo mlevi kule ametokezea, hatujui aliua watu wangapi. Huyo mlevi hatujui ni mwizi wa gari ama ni mwizi wa bunduki. Hata gari tunampatia, odua hii gari ya bishi upaki vizuri. Hatuoni kama anaweza toka nayo kwa sababu ameokoka. Na mtu akiokoka na ana ufunuo, si anamtumikia Bwana? Tunamkubali huyo mtu. Sisi mwambie jirani yako, tunamkubali huyo mtu. Sisi hebu nitumie jina Kimani mimi. Alafu Kimani amekuwa Asha hapa. Kimani has been an Asha here. And he fell into sin, which everyone in church saw. Kwa mfano, if I'm in the NYS scandal, right? So mtajua hiyo huyo ni Kimani. Then na nishikwe na niseme niliimba na nilipe. Nilipe. Serikali hiyo bilioni 90 ama 80 nilipe. Si hata serikali zimeniweka huko. Alafu nikuje church niingie pale nije kuhubiria. Actually watu wataanza kuangalia na waseme kuna watu mimi ni wa hivyo. Huyu ni hatari sana. This man is dangerous. Actually, when you greet somebody, they don't want to be associated with you. Why? What's the difference between Kimani and that man who walked in, who has murdered and killed and done all those evil things, but has given his life to the Lord and has walked in, and we have embraced him? Now the problem is where? And I pray that God can give us a revelation of what God does. When God forgives, he forgives. When God renews, he renews. When God restores, He restores. The question is, why are you becoming Adamo? Adamo. Instead of becoming Adamo star. Why are you the one who measures? Who pretend it? Who you some pepesa? Who you anaza iba? Lakini yule mlevu ameingia amerokoka. Tunataka abebe sadaka. James. Anabeba sadaka. Na una shida na yeye. Si alisema ameokoka. Alafu Kimani yule alikuwa ameokoka. Akaanguka. Hiyo sadaka uweze kupatia. Huyu jamaa NYS alisafisha. You have to be careful about it. Can God use me? That's what I'm asking. Can God use me? I'm saying God can use me, but what I need is the revelation of who He is. Because if I know who God is, I will embrace whoever God has forgiven. Because when God sets you free, you become free indeed. Do you want healing? What you need is the revelation of Jesus Christ as a healer. And once you believe He is a healer, you receive your healing. If you believe that Jesus is a provider and you receive a revelation of Him providing, you walk in His provision, your life changes. What I need is a revelation of who Jesus is. This woman got a revelation of who Jesus is. She forgot her pot, ran into the city. I'm telling you, for the first time this woman felt, I am somebody. Tell your neighbor, I am somebody. Oh, this woman felt she knows somebody. This woman behaved like she has met somebody. This woman, her character changed. Her speech and her everything was like she had seen somebody. Hallelujah. May God help you once you receive Him. Even today, once God sets you free and forgives you, then may you receive that boldness that you have known somebody. She walked into the city, smiling, not afraid of everybody. Saying, collect all the men and bring them here. Now if a lady says that and you knew her life, and she's collecting all men, what are you going to do? But she said, collect all of them. Why? Because I've seen a man. He's not like this Ampulis. I've seen a man. I have seen my life is changed. I'm no longer who I was. Now I'm a new creature. Collect all men. And all men were brought together. And she told them a simple message. Come and see a man. Now you see, friends, evangelism is so easy. Can we try? Come and see a man. That's all what you need to do. Come and see a man. Then the person will ask you, which man? And then you tell him, he has told me everything and my life is changed. Would you like to come and see this man? Now if you cannot even preach, you can tell them, come to a church and see our Savior. Evangelism, God can use you. Tell your neighbor, God can use you. All what we need is a revelation. Now see, just live, because God, if He used Paul, a mother, you know the first people to run away from Him were not other Pharisees, they were the Christians. They said, even Ananias was afraid, and I pray for him. And the Lord says, He is going to be my servant. If God can say so about that, how about you? God has declared you also His servant. Now, son, come and see a man. It is by revelation. I want to finish at that point. I want to ask the worship team to come. We sing the song that we sang. We sing the second stanza. And if you're here, maybe you have been a thermometer. May God make you a thermostat in the house of the Lord to encourage others to serve Him. In high school, you did what you did, but now you are not doing it. Ask the Lord to revive you. Remember, evangelism is just telling people to come and see who? Come and see a man. Come and see a man. Come and see a man. I don't know the last time you witnessed to someone. The last time you even told the compound where you live that you have a church. They even don't know you have a church. Tell them to come to church. Tell them that there is a Savior who can save them.